Anyhow, I'm going to turn this program now over to Scott Golden. We'll begin this program, and about halfway through, we'll be able to talk about some more things. So I don't want you to be sitting on the billfold when that time comes.
In constant sorrow all his days,
and anywhere from 2 years to 70 something, 76 years of experience. So it is really interesting group to play with and direct, and to see how musicians mingle. And but you'll hear more about some of the members here a little later. But right now, we're going to do Way Up on the Mountain. Laurie and Craig are going to take us in on that. All ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
I was down in the valley, waiting on the valley, when the Savior heard my people cry. There was darkness all around me when my Savior found me, way down in the valley of despair.
Then I told him all my troubles, all my joys he doubled. Now I'm way up on the mountain, rejoicing in his care.
I was down in the valley, way down in the valley, when the Savior heard my people cry. Now I'm back up on the mountain, way up on the mountain, drinking from the fountain, never shall I cry.
Keep on sunny side, always on sunny side. Keep on sunny side.
Banner's going to sing this one for it. And Banner's been playing with his family since he was 10 years old. He and his identical twin brother, Kenneth, and their sons and their grandsons, and I think a few other branches on their family tree all get together, and they play up in the Swanee Music Park on Cape. So he's going to take us on the railway to heaven. Go ahead, man.
Thank you.
from Matthew. The ten virgins are, they're giving us to light the way for a bridegroom. And being prepared means having plenty of oil, having your wicks trimmed, and being ready no matter when the bridegroom comes. And when he's delayed, it doesn't come till midnight. Only five of the virgins have enough oil to keep their lamps burning. The other five are disowned because they ran out of oil. And that's what this next song is about. It's called Oil My Vessel. And Sarah's going to sing this for us.
Before she joined us.
But after she joined us, she started playing fiddle. I know what you're thinking, but there is a very subtle difference between the violin and the fiddle. The fiddle, violin has four strings on it. The fiddle has four strings on it. Then this next song is probably the first one we ever played as a group, I think. Willa Beeney started my grandma. Laurie's going to sing me some poems.
Don't burn. Hey! know there's not too many printouts, but for those that have a bulletin, look at the front cover with all our pictures on it. A lot of you may know this, some of you may not, so I've got to share it with everybody. The yellow tie fellow, that's me. I'm not wearing glasses, but here's the funny part, that's not my body. I was out of town when we got this taken, and flippantly I said to Scott, you know, just get someone to get in there and just plug my head on there. Well, they got our pastor, Jimmy Moore, to stand in. And so, I mean, I'm totally honored to have the pastor's body in this show. So, anyway, you know the inside secret. It's on Facebook. It cracks me up every time I see it. Oh, goodness. You ready, Scott? I think so.
One, two, three.
I guess I'm not ready. I'm still thinking about Pastor Jimmy's body. I guess.
Oh, by the way, and there's something interesting about this song. It was written by William York, and he was the bass player for Hank Williams.
Isn't that pretty?
And I'll tell you a little bit more about William York later on. It's kind of fascinating. We're going to go ahead and start this. One, two, three.
correspondence of Bluegrass before. When Dr. John Kelly comes, Banner's here with one of the thugs. He knows every song that's ever been written and not written for Bluegrass. Ain't that right, Banner?
No.
Like water coming out of here. How many of you know what the lay leader of the Emory County District is? This is it. The first female. And a friend of mine.
Studying about that good old
list of violinists that they would like to be like and like to play like. And I've got a whole list of them myself. But if I had to pick the top three guitarists, it would probably be Chet Atkins, Tommy Emmanuel, and Mike Duffy. Well, Chet Atkins is dead and Tommy's in Australia. And that's actually a good thing because Mike sings better than either one of those other guys. So I'm going to help him out on the guitar a little bit. He's going to sing one of those. This is from a Ricky Skaggs album, which was written by Peter Rowan, who drank a lot of bluegrass stuff over the years. This is called Soldier of the Cross.
Carry the sword.
Is there anything he can't play? He also has a trumpet, I thought of that. So is there anything else I have left on?
Hey, I try. I don't play many answers, but I play with a lot of them.
You all ready to go?
I'm all ready to go.
All right.
How are you doing? Like anyone knows what that sounds like.
So I tried it, and sure enough, it but the biggest complaint I've gotten about banjos is how loud it is. I mean, you know, you got the strings going across the bridge, and the bridge is sitting on top of a drum head, and the drum head is mounted on a brass ring that vibrates readings like a bell. Then you put a reflector on the back of it. All that noise has got to go out to the front. I mean, it's just a loud instrument. You can't do anything to change it, you know. And I should have known better. Next time I was practicing, Laurie got on the internet and decided she'd do a little research. Found a website that sold banjo mutes. Who took it, you know? So she bought me one. I don't have a problem with singing circles. There's a disclaimer, though. It makes a lot of noise the first time you use it. After that, you're good to go. So I had to buy me another banjo. We're going to get Charles to sing one for us. It's called Waiting at the Gate.
Holy, I'm doing a crime opening.
we might need that.
Try and own into the world. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
now. I imagine every one of you was wondering what it would be like to be able to participate in the community bluegrass group, aren't you?
Yeah.
Are
you?
Because you're getting ready to.
Fixing.
You're fixing this. If you look at your program, you have the lyrics for the next three songs. We've got to do them all in a row. It's a sing-along. And so y'all sing along. And the band's going to get started. We're going to have Banner and Woke to kind of demonstrate the age range in our group. We're going to have the youngest in our, we put that there. We're going to have our most mature and our most in line. Okay, we're going to ask Amy back. Okay, now, get started on a solo.
Oh,
nicest singer in the world, Jeff, and that's your husband.
Thank you. See? Go.
Right, before we play this last song, there's a few people I'd like to acknowledge. Randy Davidson, sound tech. Sitting in the pews here, he designed our logo. One more person I'd like to recognize is Tom Moore, the director of Christian Youth, who was part of the idea that started this group, and he continued to support us with the resources in the facilities. So we appreciate that. Thanks, Tom. And now, get ready, because you're not going to be able to sit still for this last one.
If you know it, join in and help me out.